In a small beautiful village, a poor woman, Kaberi, lived with her husband. She was very hard working. She used to work like there is no tomorrow in the fields, plowing and watering and working hard on every piece of land, while her husband snoring away happily at home. They were very poor farmers with a small patch of land where nothing seemed to grow. The land of hers was right next to a temple. A thief came to the village and wanted to steal the coins that were given as offering in the temple, and even the ornaments on the idol. The only way into the temple was by digging his way in from Kaberi's land, but how could he do anything with Kaberi there? One day she was working in the field, trying to dig the ground so she could sow some seeds. A man with a big mustache appeared beside her. Hello everyone, this is Niva, and I am here again with another summarized video. This is a story from the book Grandma Bag of Story by Sudha Murthy. I hope you like this video, and if you do, like and subscribe.
Hello dear.
Hi sister. Why are you working so hard on this barren land? I will give you 1000 rupees, sell it to me.
No, I am not interested.
That made Kaberi really confused. As in, why would someone would buy a land and that also a dry one with no use in a really high cost?
If it is less, I will give you 1050. No, I will give you 2000. I can give you 5000. Whatever you will ask for.
And now she was sure about it. He surely had some evil plans. So she wanted to fool him.
No, I will never sell this land. It belonged to my ancestors. Now we are poor, but I have been told once our family was very rich. Though we lost a lot of it, but much of it is still buried here by one of our ancestors to keep it safe from robbers. My husband found a clue to the location of hidden treasure just a week back. That's why I am digging this hard earth, not to sow seed, but actually looking for hidden treasure.
And the foolish man thought she is too innocent. That is why she is sharing this important information and wanted to take advantage of it. He preferred to steal the treasure beneath earth than the temple one.
Okay sister, I understand. After all, it is your family treasure. Only you should get it. All the very best.
In the night, Kaberi packed up her tools and headed to her home. At midnight, when everything became quiet and the night creatures were coming out of their home, the thief crept into the field. All night he kept on digging, looking for treasure, but of course there was no sign of it, as there was no such thing. By the time dawn broke, he realized Kaberi had made him a fool, and all he could do now was get away from field fast. When Kaberi reached the field, she grinned to herself. Just as she had expected, the thief had spent the night digging up the land nicely for her. All she needed to do now was to sow the seeds. She worked hard in the field for next few months and managed to grow some good crop. She sold those and finally they had some money. With those, Kaberi brought some jewelry. After few months, the thief came again. He trimmed his long mustache, tied a colorful turban, pretending to be a salesman. He saw Kaberi and was surprised to see her wearing jewelry and nice sari.
Now this poor lady is wearing jewelry. She must have located the hidden treasure. I will look in her house and find the rest of her money.
That night he appeared at Kaberi's house.
Hello, I am a traveler and don't have a place to sleep. Please can you give me a shelter for tonight?
No problem, you can take rest in our veranda.
Kaberi glimpsed the man from inside of the house and identified him. As it was the same old thief, he must have planned a robbery.
Oh dear, your dear aunt is all alone at night and has asked us to come stay with her. Let's go there for the night. Don't worry for jewels, I have hidden them in little holes in the house walls. No one will suspect the hidden spot. Brother, you can sleep in the veranda, the house is locked. Here is some food and water for you. We will come back in the morning.
Okay sister, I will take care.
Kaberi's husband was gazing her confused. As in, which aunt and which jewel was she talking about? The thief could not believe his luck, so he started tapping. Tap tap tap, kick, punch, shove, he prowled and he tapped, he kicked and he pushed the wall, hoping that he will find the jewels. Finally he tore down all the walls. But of course nothing he found. Exhausted as the sun rose, he fled away before Kaberi and his husband returned.
See what the bad man has done to our house. You gave him food and shelter. You made me come with you, leaving the man alone.
I had planned it all along. See, I saved money from our last crop to rebuild the house. I was thinking to call in some laborers to help tear it down, but our guest did it for us. Now we can make a large house for ourselves, just the way we wanted.
Many months passed away. The thief was burning to take revenge.
How can she fool me? I will surely take my revenge now.
One day he dressed up as a Bengal seller and started wandering in the village. Kabri spotted him and knew who he was at once.
Friend, are not you getting any for yourself?
Yeah, I would have loved to get some for myself, but ever since that good-for-nothing thief tried to steal all our money by tearing down our house, I have hidden everything in a little hole in a tree which is in the woods.
Which tree?
I am not saying which tree, but it is at least in a safe and sound place in the forest.
Thief looked at Kaveri and saw that Kaveri is now wearing an ordinary sari with not so many ornaments at all. Then all the women turned around in astonishment at the crash with which the Bengal seller flung down his collection of bangles and made off for the forest. In the forest the thief searched high and low for the jewels, he climbed tree, poked around the bushes, got bitten, scratched and growled at searching for jewels. Everyone praised Kaveri for her quick wit. In fooling the thief, she continued to work hard and made more money from farming and become rich old lady. Even her husband was shamed into giving up laziness and started helping her.
Thank you so much for watching.